life by analogy with a journey, with a pilgrimage, which had a serious purpose at the end, but they was to get to that end. Success or whatever it is, or maybe heaven. But we missed the point the whole way along. It was a musical thing. Chose to sing one dance while music was being played. So then, this is, as I said, my basic metaphysical assumption, which I'm seeing from you, that existence is musical in nature. That is to say that it is not singing, it is the play of all kinds of
back on for a while, so will you stay with me? real one if you always play the game. I wanna be who I wanna be, but I don't know who that is. Don't wanna be who they want me to be, 'cause I don't know.
I am told through different lenses.
You are too thin.
You are too thick. Is there no in between?
I am told I am too big.
Too ambitious.
Too loud.
Too much for you.
Too much for them.
Am I too much? I started off dancing with the two-step trying to boogie on East LA cruise night. Lowrider oldies and funk music filled the air. It was then that I knew my life would consist of me always coming back to that one and two, one and two, one and two. Is what I whisper beneath my breath and attempt to calm down. I see no one who walks, talks, or looks like me. No one who does the one and two-step like me to lowrider oldies and funk. Wandering for those who look and move like me. People do not see me. They only see my movement, not me. Seeing me is understanding that my brown, loud body is often refused to be listened to. Seeing me is noticing my Latin flavor will always show regardless of what style. Seeing me as a dancer is understanding that everything I've endured becomes embodied, forever to be shown. When I walk with my street swag, speak my very broken Spanglish, move around with awareness of who I am, and dance on the one and two to lowrider oldies and funk, it is an embodiment of my people and community. My body is assumed to run the streets, to be your typical Latina. Nah, man. This body was meant to move on the one and two. It was meant to take up space. My body is meant to dance. So when I dance, see me, not just my movement. See more than just a stereotype. See my experience that have shaped me. See my brown, loud body demanding to be heard. Demanding to be respected. See me.
Growing up, my body was a stem, fragile and easily broken from tormentuous comments. Mis curvas y mi piel son oro to me, unlike others who disagree. In my mother's tendering voice, she would say, they are beautiful living blossoms. Tú vales mucho. Tu piel, tus pies y tu cuerpo valen como esta flor. She would help them grow, feeding them and me knowledge. I aspired to be like the girasol, strong and beautiful. I was a reflection of madurez. Dirt and rica agua created this beautiful body. My body is imperfect through their lens, underweight or overweight, a never-ending war. This has become a remedy, a ripple in my society, destroyed by replicas of the typical kid next door stomping all over my mother's hard work. This girasol is mine to grow. Isn't this home? Mi cuerpo. Not perfect, pero ahí la lleva. I am worthy of unconditionally loving myself. I'm in control. Ya no más. Everywhere I go, I leave a trail of sunflower seeds, living a little bit of amor y alegría as my lens.
I looked in the mirror and I asked myself to be friends with my body. I take a pause. I check for the no arms, stretch marks, or cellulite is showing. Big arms, too many stretch marks, fat body, thick thighs, too much cellulite. These are words spoken to me about me. I take a pause because I am scared of society. I am scared of society not accepting a brown woman. I am scared of society not accepting a big brown woman. I'm scared of society not accepting a big brown woman who wants to make art. My body is a canvas. My thick legs move to the rumba. My stretch marks tell a story of growing and becoming a woman. My hips guide me to the next step. My skin is community. My body is a reflection of mi mamá, mi abuela, y mi bisabuela. I take the shape of strength and resilience. I take a pause because I blame society, yet I forget to realize I am a part of society. I do not have to be scared. I do not have to be apologetic. Underweight or overweight, my body will continue to be a canvas, a statement, and a reflection of mi antepasados. My body is my art. I looked in the mirror and reminded myself, your body is your best friend.
Azúcar. you trust what you see?
I'd say in general, I do believe that what I see is existing. And I think a lot of that comes from having the reassurance of people around me as well.
How do you know what's real?
It could be very possible that everyone around you is just created for one person. Just a little food for thought.
Where do you feel the most comfortable?
In places I consider home. And home isn't really a location for me, it's more of a feeling.
How do you perceive time?
Well, the things that I do to fill up a day impact how I view the time spent. But also, it's just such a strange concept that the Earth has been around for billions of years, and I'm just going to exist in maybe 100 of them.
How do you know your life isn't flashing before your eyes?
I think that is really just based on perspective. If you're taking time to notice where you are and who you are in that moment, then you have the ability to slow time down for yourself.
What are your thoughts on déjà vu?
Déjà vu is really just when you are in a situation very similar to something that's happened in your past, and your brain thinks that it is experiencing the exact same thing.
What does it mean to be unique?
I can't say that the word has much value. Everything is individualistic on its own, and I kind of don't believe in the word unique.
What's mankind's biggest flaw?
The initial flaw was selfishness, but I think we've found ways to make that good. I want to say our need to be individuals, but that's also an excellent thing, to be independent-minded.
How do you know anything behind you is real?
And it's not like you need to know. If something's behind you, you don't really need it. It's in the past or not in front of you where you need to go.
How would you explain the sensation of feeling someone's presence, even though you can't see them?
You get the feeling that there's just someone near you and you can feel their presence. Some people have a stronger presence than others.
How do you know you're awake?
I have no idea. I don't know if I'm awake right now.